you here with us again today as we start our curriculum again, our second week of Broken. As you can see, I've added to my little collection of volunteers. We've added Acelyn and Londyn to come help us today. And we are super excited to have a little bit more girls in the program. We are ready to do praise and worship. Are you guys ready to do praise and worship with us?
Yeah.
Awesome. Who do you think is going to outdo each other today? You think it's going to be the girls or do you think it'll be the boys?
Boys.
You think it's going to be the boys? What do you think, Acelyn? Think the girls are going to sing louder than the boys today? Yeah, she's super shy. We're going to work her out of that. So boys and girls, get up. Let's start our praise and worship this morning and worship Jesus together.
When night has fallen, when fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. I've decided I'm not giving up, 'cause you won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Echo in my soul. There's no stopping what you have started until it is complete. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. I've decided I'm not giving up, 'cause you won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on.
Promise.
Yeah. worship this morning?
Yes.
So who did you hear the most? Did you hear more girls or did you hear more boys?
Pretty much boys.
Pretty much boys? But you've got girls all in your house. That's okay. You can still hear them, right? All right. Well, Londyn, guess what? It's finally time to watch our intro video. And since we've been talking about being broken and how our lives are broken in sin sometimes, we're going to watch a video on how to help others who are broken. So, Londyn, how can you help your mom around the house? If we're just talking about helping others, how can you help your mom around the house?
Like making my bed and by cleaning up my room.
But I bet you don't really dirty up your room very much, do you? I didn't figure that. You girls probably just keep it clean all the time, right?
Yeah.
Well, are you ready to watch the intro video with me? Let's see how we can help others.
Everybody, it's me, Ashton, and I'm here to continue our series called Broken. We've been talking about the story called Humpty Dumpty. You remember?
Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty Dumpty back together again.
It's sad when people's lives are broken by sin. And it's really sad when someone who's living their life for Jesus falls into temptation and sin. Their lives were whole, but now they're broken because of a huge mistake. You know, when another Christian falls into sin, we have a big choice to make. Will we point our finger at them and make fun? Will we gossip and talk to other people about what they did? Will we get mad at them and stop being their friend? Or will we do what Jesus did? Remember Jesus' disciple Peter? After Jesus was arrested, Peter was surrounded by several people. Most of the people asked Peter if he knew Jesus, but he denied that he knew Jesus. He even cursed. That really broke God's heart. Talk about being broken.
After Jesus rose from the dead, Jesus found Peter by the sea. Peter fell to Jesus' feet and begged for his forgiveness. He didn't yell at Peter or tell him how bad he was. Instead, he kindly and gently helped Peter back on the right path. And Peter went on to be one of the greatest people in the Bible.
That's exactly what we need to do when someone makes a mistake or falls away from God. Whenever they come back to God to get their broken lives back together again, we need to focus on helping their lives back on the right path. And that brings us to today's big idea. Today's big idea says, I gotta help those who are broken by sin. So every time you hear this sound,
hey, what's the big idea?
Stand up on your feet and say, I gotta help those who are broken by sin. And that's today's big idea. Well, we've got a lot to learn about today about how to help people who are broken by sin. Until next time, this is Ashton reminding you, all the king's horses and all the king's men can't, but God can.
Okay, today we are going to be talking about how to help those who have been broken by sin.
Fire! Oh!
Wow, okay.
How are you doing there? I'm Chuck Who.
We know who you are, Chuck, but what's up with the crazy hat?
Crazy looking hat?
Yeah.
Well, it's an awesome hat. I mean, where's my hat club?
You're in a hat club?
Well, yeah, that's right. I've been going to the Holy Rollers Hat Club for a while now.
Wow.
It's a Christian club where we make our own hats and stuff, but that's not the point right now. I'm really, really mad.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Why are you so upset today?
Well, my friend, so-called friend, Patricia.
What do you mean, so-called friend?
Well, she goes to church, and she's been in the Holy Rollers Hat Club for a long time now. But the other day, I found out something just awful. She's a sinner.
Excuse me?
I said, She's a sinner. Turns out she stole some money from the people in the Holy Rulers Hat Club. She used the money to buy a hat bigger and better than mine. It's made out of turkey feathers, but I mean, it's a full-grown turkey on top of their head. I mean, it's kind of weird, don't you think? But it even has a built-in gobble that makes a noise every time you push a button.
Wait. Now, Chuck, just hold on there. Just because she bought a better hat than you doesn't mean you should be talking about her that way.
Well, it's not the hat that I'm so upset up. It's the fact that she stole my money. She's a sinner. It's just not right. She's not supposed to sin like that if she goes to church. If she's a Christian, she's supposed to be perfect.
Well, now, hold on there, Chuck. Christians aren't perfect, you know. Sometimes we make mistakes. Sometimes they do things. Christians make mistakes. They fall into temptations. But that doesn't mean we should get all angry and...
Well, of course we should be. If someone is going to sin like that, then we have every right to be angry at them and tell them what we think. They're just a stinky, rotten, no good looking person, sinner.
Whoa.
They deserve to be drop kicked next week. But it just makes me want to tell everybody I know that she did it.
Well, I completely understand why you're upset there, Chuck. But in fact, when somebody we know falls into sin, that's not at all how we should treat them. In fact, I think you need to take a listen to what Mr. Boing says in our power verse today. So, actually, our power verse says, if another Christian is overcome by sin, okay, you should gently and humbly help them back onto the right path.
Okay, well, that sounds wonderful and all, but to be quite honest with you, it's kind of hard not to be mad at her for sinning like that. Don't you think?
Well, yeah, I don't think so. I know it's okay to be upset, but one of the things that helps is you're supposed to be gentle toward people who fall into sin. When I remember that all of us have sinned and are capable of making mistakes, if it were you who had made the mistake, would you want everybody to be gentle with you and to help put you back on the right track?
Well, I never thought about that way. But I guess I shouldn't be so hard on her, especially since she has returned for the, especially since she returned the money and asked for forgiveness. I guess I should be probably a little bit, little nicer to Kung Fu Master.
Yeah, I think that's probably a great idea.
Well, you taught me something very important. I will talk to my friend Patricia and tell her I'm praying for her, and I hope she goes back to her right path.
I think you're on the right track now.
Okay then. I guess I'll see you kids later. And I'm Chuck Fu, and kick it. Oh, almost forget my hat.
Yeah, don't forget the crazy hat.
Woo!
So, boys and girls, we're going to get right on into that power verse, and we're going to learn it together.
Whee! Hello, kids! My name is Super! Super Duck! Boy! That's super ridiculous! Get that thing off! We have better things to do! We have to say the power verse! My mother is cooking spaghetti tonight!
Hold your horses there, Dr. Von Snutty! I will teach the kids today's power verse! Today's power verse says, if another Christian is overcome by sin, you should gently and humbly help them back onto the right path! Galatians 6:1. Wonderful job, me! That's exactly right! Wasn't that a good part of us? I think I said it pretty good!
Yes. Well, you did say it good, but remember, the boys and I will say it better! So on the count of three, boys, rise up to your feet and let's do this together! One, a two, a three! If another Christian is overcome by sin, you should gently and humbly help them back on the right path! Galatians 6:1. Booyah! Shaka-laka-laka-laka-laka! Ha! Boys, sit down! I told you, I have done it again!
You, sir, have bad breath! But girls, with all the nice minty breath, stand up on your feet. Here we go, and let's do the power bus on the count of three. One, two, three. If another Christian is overcome by sin, you should gently and humbly help them back onto the right path. Galatians 6:1. Wonderful job, girls! Very, very good! Yes, 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 yes! You may have a seat, Dr. Vaughn, kid! When we see other people wandering off the path that are broken by their own sin, we have to help them! Even though they've made a boo-boo, we've got to make sure to help them get back on the right path, the path that God wants them to be on! Yes, 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 yes! So, kids, I want you to stand up and say the power verse with me on the count of three! Here we go! One! Two, three! If another Christian is overcome by sin, you should gently and humbly help them back onto the right path. Galatians 6:1. Great job, everybody! You may have a seat, have a seat! Yes, 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 yes!
You startle me every time you yell! You did a fantastic job! You better be glad I have spaghetti waiting on me at the house! For now, I'm Dr. Von Hickersnut!
And I'm Dr. Boing! Until next time, kids!
Okay, guys, it's finally time for story time, which is kind of one of my favorite times. So remember last week when we talked a little bit about the nursery rhyme Humpty Dumpty?
Yeah.
Do y'all remember the story? Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to read the book again today, and it's going to go a little bit farther in the story. Can y'all help me read it?
Sure.
All right, here we go. Londyn, can you start us off?
Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall.
Perfect. Acelyn? Oh, she's being really shy. You want to help her out, Londyn?
Humpty Dumpty had a great fall.
He did.
All the king's horses.
And?
All the king's men.
Yep.
Couldn't put Humpty together again.
Ugh. That is so sad when we see Humpty Dumpty all broken, right? Mm-hmm. But we're going to go a little farther in the story today. But his bunny friends found a way. Grayson, help me out.
To pick Humpty Dumpty. Hip, hip, hooray.
Can you believe those bunnies found a way to put Humpty Dumpty back together again?
Yeah, that's so funny.
That is so funny. I've never heard that ending of the story. Have you guys?
No.
Me either. But it worked out perfect because in our lesson today of broken, we're learning how to help others who have fallen into sin. So just like those bunnies helped Humpty Dumpty, we are going to learn how to help others who have fallen into sin. Can I use you guys as some examples today?
Yeah.
So when Humpty Dumpty was on the wall, do you think maybe he made a silly mistake and made a crazy decision? What if someone pushed Humpty Dumpty off the wall? What if that's how he fell? Or what if Humpty Dumpty was dancing on the wall and he knew he wasn't supposed to be dancing on the wall and then he fell off? Wouldn't that be crazy?
Yeah, and that is a bad decision because